A very busy day today. We had the legendary MC8 in the building.
I saw that.
Right?
I'm your co-host.
My co-host today is the one and only DJ Vice.
Yeah.
An exciting day for Third Floor Radio. Vice, every time I try to tell everybody about the history of us, they think that I'm making it up.
It's all real. Third Floor Radio to me, it's like OG. It's like legendary. It's part of
the
roots.
Can you say that to the camera?
It's part of the roots. Third Floor Radio. I mean,
right.
I grew up on that.
You know what we do here? It's Third Floor Radio because we take a journey through the past, through the present, through the future. It's three floors.
I like that.
So we're going back. Ready?
Okay. Yes.
Baby Vice.
Baby Vice.
Tell me about him. Like, when did he start DJing and why?
I don't even know because there wasn't even that many DJs around me at the time. It was just me and my boy who taught me how to DJ, DJ Splice out of LA as well. And at that time, I mean, I don't know. I didn't know anything. It was kind of, you know what's cool about it? It was just like, you just got to do whatever you wanted. No one judged you or no one, there was no rules to DJing or anything, you know, you just DJ. So I went towards radio and I got on Power 106 in LA, which was a big milestone for my career. Yeah. And being in LA as a DJ, getting on the air right out of high school in 1998, I got on Power 106.
How was that process? How did you get on Power 106?
That's the hustle.
Tell the story.
That's mixtape after mixtape after mixtape. And really just pushing to them that, you know, I'm that DJ. And at the time, I honestly was even the title of an open format DJ because Power 106 played house and hip hop at the time.
Yeah.
So I was playing house records into hip hop and house and hip hop going back and forth. And finally, they just kind of recognized the skills and they're like, this little kid can DJ, and they tested me out on the air. So
what was that like? Like leaving radio and actually, you know, getting
same thing. I was like, all right, now I'm reaching all of LA. And I think at the time our listenership was like 1.8 million people. And I was like, wow, that's great. Now how
that's
do I go even
good,
further?
Right?
Yeah. How do I go even further outside of LA? So from there, I got the opportunity through DJ AM, another like, you know, LA guy holding it down in the Hollywood scene. And I got to go to Vegas and play my first big room Vegas set. So this is probably 2004, 2005, and I did a set in Vegas, and it was kind of like, go ahead and do anything and everything you want to do.
Right.
So I was playing hip-hop and rock and 80s and house and just anything I want to do. The crowd was open to it, you know? Vegas people lose their mind.
Vice, you've had a million artists asked to work with you. You know, you've worked with Linkin Park. Why Mike Taylor?
Because you can just, when you hear his voice on the records, like it spoke to me, as corny as it may sound, like, you know what I mean? But like, and it's true. I mean, I grew up on radio and hearing demo after demo and new, it's really hard to hear a new artist and be like, done, that's it. Like, but that's the first record that Cheap Shot played for me in the car. I was like, dude, I gotta work with this guy.
Because we get a feeling when we hear certain records. And when I played it for the first time, I mean, the Skee247 team has it in rotation. They play it on Kiss as well. So there is that feeling that you get.
Yeah, and the record, and Mike had already written the lyrics to this record, so it already told my story as well in a different angle, in a sense. Like, I wanna go further. And we keep saying, like, what's the next level? What's the next level? And mine is to keep traveling to more and more places and keep the music surrounding me. And
so, Mike, tell me what's next for you guys. Where are you guys going?
I don't know. Tomorrow.
Friday.
We're at Sutra.
In Orange County.
You know that I have a place out there and I'm going to come because you're going to perform it live?
Oh, it's going to be crazy. It's going to be cracking.
Okay. What else is planned after OC? Where are you going?
We have actually, for me, I go to Vegas. I have Sundance coming up. We have another show on Valentine's Day. We're doing Scottsdale, Arizona.
Nice.
I still have, I play all types of parties, whether it's a big mainstream club, a big room, whether it's a festival, or I'm in New York during Super Bowl playing for like a big party. So I'm kind of all over the place.
I know you are. Just the Vice out there.
Good things.
And so our dugout Third Floor Radio DJ Vice reunion is coming up.
Here we go. Yeah.
We got to bring it up. We're going to do a house party. You got to bring out all the vinyl.
I like it.
I know you got all your vinyl.
It's all going to skip and be scratched and it's all going to sound bad. But,
some Kirkland Clan. And
exactly.
All right. So now we're going to see and hear the special voicing. But before that, anything you guys want to say just to the fans?
I think just thank you first and foremost on my side, Vice. And if you can just keep up with me on @DJVice on all formats, I always try to keep up with all my people and hit them back.
All right. So up next, we got Third Floor Radio exclusive DJ Reneli. You ready? World is our playground.
I can see you in the crowd. See you cause your heart lights up the sky. Can hear you screaming loud. Roaring like the thunder in the night. Feel the day. up. I'm coming to you in the night falls. New York, LA, Miami, no, it won't be long. Then it's London and Paris and Tokyo, Brazil. Don't you worry, I'll soon be around. Because the world is our playground. Everywhere in the world is our playground.
Third Floor Radio exclusive.
We threw you on the spot.
It was cities. I was like, oh man, okay.
DJ Vice and I am Mike Taylor.
Yeah.
Can you do one thing for me? Can you sing Walnut?
That's the city I'm from.
Walnut. Does it work? Walnut. Walnut.
Yeah. Walnut.
Walnut. I'm coming to you in the night
fall. How about Eagle Rock? Eagle Rock.
That's the city.
Eagle Rock.
How about the stereotypes that just walked in the building? Stereotypes.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that.
Amazing producers in here.